We have this lovely robot machine behind us, which is worth 2 million.
Into medicine training and or surgical training.
They go to lectures, go to the specialties and experience.
If you clicked to this video, I assume you are at some point in your life where you are unsure or confused about which specialty you're gonna go for, or even about getting into medical school. So in today's video, I'm interviewing dear Dr. Dhanji, who is a registrar in cardiothoracic surgery in one of the most renowned hospitals in London, at the hospital where I did my clinical attachment, by the way. So thanks to that clinical attachment, I got the chance to meet him and ask him to do this interview where I'm asking 5 questions that will provide invaluable insights from a thoracic surgeon at one of London's premier hospitals. So without further ado, let's dive into the interview.
So today I'll be asking several questions, but before we start, would you like to introduce yourself briefly?
Yeah, sure. First of all, thank you for asking me to have this interview. It's very privileged. So my name is Arohan Dhanji. Everyone calls me Al because it's the easiest to pronounce. They can't pronounce my full name. I'm a current registrar, more in thoracic surgery now for the last, probably at least 6-7 years now in thoracic surgery. I've been working here at some of my colleagues' hospital in central London, St. Paul's. And it's a pleasure to work here and a pleasure to have yourself to visit us and see what we do.
My pleasure. All right, so I'm moving on with my questions. So what inspired you to pursue a career in medicine or in thoracic surgery?
Sure. So it's hard, really. My family are not medicine orientated. Mm-hmm. My father, when he saw blood, he collapsed. My mother never was able. So no family members were in medicine. Mm-hmm. The first one was my brother, who's 3 years older than me. Mm-hmm. He pursued a career in medicine and is now a GP, but left England and now in Adelaide, Australia. Mm-hmm. So he enjoys it very much there. And then I followed. I like anatomy. That interested me. I like meeting people, like yourself and other people, talk to people, so that interested me. Mm-hmm. I like talking to people, so I could never become an anaesthetist because they want to see me. So I could never do an anaesthetist because they wouldn't talk back to me. But yeah, so I like meeting people, I like interacting with people, mm-hmm. and it's a cliche, but I like helping people as much as I can. So that's what took me into a pathway into medicine.
All right, that was lovely. And my second question is, could you share some of the most rewarding and challenging aspects of being a registrar or being a thoracic surgeon at a hospital like St. Bartholomew?
Yeah. So I think one of the rewarding things of being a registrar here, it's a very busy unit. I think you see it for yourself. It's renowned, and there's a lot of things happening mm-hmm. here that doesn't happen in normal hospitals. Mm-hmm. We are a cardiothoracic centre, or the thorax centre, they've named it here. Mm-hmm. A lot of things we do here are first as well in the world, like navigation bronchoscopy. Mm-hmm. We have this lovely robot machine behind us, which is worth 2 million. We're one of the few hospitals that has its own robot. In thoracic surgery, whereas most other institutions around the world, mm-hmm. it's shared with specialities like urology, oncology, but we have our own one just purely for thoracic surgery. Mm-hmm. So in that way, we see a lot of operations, mm-hmm. we get to take part in those operations. So that's quite rewarding. Mm-hmm. And generally, just treating people or diagnosing illnesses is rewarding. We're just little bits in the big wall. We're just doing our little bits, but we do our best.
Okay. All right, that's great. Moving on with the next one. As a medical professional, what advice would you give to the medical students who are considering specializing in thoracic surgery or surgery in general?
So if they specialize in thoracic surgery, I think they're on the right path. Of course, I would say that.
You have been trying to appreciate me.
Yeah, failed. Yes. But no. So I think the medical student coming into medicine per se, get a wide experience as much as you can. Don't stay in bed all day. Go to lectures, go to the specialities, and experience different specialities. You need to see what you like, what you don't like. Mm-hmm. For me, I never really had an interest in general practitioner or medicine, but surgery really fascinated me. Mm-hmm. Doing things with your hands, mm-hmm. the skills of your hand, or skills with the instruments. The robot, yes. So that's really interested me for surgery, and then decide what kind of surgery. Mm-hmm. And I remember to this day the first time I did cardiac surgery, when the registrar in front of me had opened the chest and exposed the heart, and he said, "Give me your hand." So I gave him my hand, and he put my hand on a human's heart. Mm-hmm. And to feel a human heart pumping against your hand, I thought, this is amazing, you know. This is absolutely, it was absolutely amazing. So that inspired me to look more into cardiothoracic surgery. And then, as I said, I've done cardiac surgery, and now I'm more into thoracic surgery. You definitely get more sleep in thoracic surgery than cardiac surgery. So that's a good bonus. So experience everything, and then try to decide what you want. Here, generally, you go three paths, either medicine, surgery, or general practitioner. Mm-hmm. It has the path you choose. Mm-hmm. And then once you go down the surgery or the medicine path, mm-hmm. you can choose what medical field or what surgical field. Mm-hmm. Neurosurgery, ENT surgery, plastic surgery, fibroplastic mm-hmm. surgery, mm-hmm. orthopedic, or medicine. You can go to gastro, upper GI.
Internal medicine training and for surgical training.
For surgical training, exactly. Yeah.
Follow.
Exactly. Exactly. So you go to one of those paths, and then you do the exam at the end of those paths, mm-hmm. whether it's medicine MRCP or whether you do surgery MRCS, mm-hmm. And you need to get those under your belt, and then go into the specialty, and then do a final exam at the end, mm-hmm. With FRCS for surgery. So just don't rush. Take your time, experience everything, and then take lots of advice from people, and then you'll hopefully work out what you like and what you don't like. Because you've got to remember, this is your life, the future. Mm-hmm. You know, so you can change in future. People who do MRCS and go to MRCP or vice versa, but it's very hard, very difficult. Mm-hmm. So take your time, speak to lots of people, get advice from people, and then you can hope to decide.
Mm-hmm. Right. That was lovely. And my last question is, what advice would you offer to students who are currently studying outside of the UK but considering pursuing a career in the United States?
Yeah, so again, the first thing is to come to the United Kingdom, I think it's quite expensive. Mm-hmm. So save up or try to get a scholarship. I'm generous, but I'm not that generous. But yes, it must be quite difficult. There's lots of hoops to go through.
And you feel the things that are important is to be thoughtful, because I felt too overwhelmed with the process, because I've been emailing and no responses.
Yeah. The first thing is just find people who've done it before you.
Yeah.
Don't invent the wheel. Mm-hmm. People have done it before, so just speak to them first. Mm-hmm. Get advice. And see what they did, how they did it, and what was good for them, what was bad for them. And try to learn the good things and try to forget the bad things. Mm-hmm. So, get advice. And then remember, UK is massive. Don't always think London's the best. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I would think outside London, you may, as a student or as your training, you may get more opportunity outside London. Mm-hmm. And outside London is much more greener and much nicer sometimes.
Yeah.
Fresher air. Mm-hmm. Whereas London is really expensive and very hustle bustle, mm-hmm. everything. But also, London has other advantages and busy hospitals.
Yeah.
So everything is positive and negatives. Mm-hmm. But generally, speak to people before you come, get advice, get all your paperwork done, keep up to date, nice TV, mm-hmm. approach people, mm-hmm. and always ask and we don't ask them yet. So keep asking for things, advice, for, and try to enjoy yourself over here.
So thank you so much for accepting my offer. It was so nice.
Good, it's pleasure, and hope it helps other people. And if anyone wants to come and work here or see what we do, more than welcome to.
Okay, thank you so much.
You're welcome, thank you.
So that unfortunately brings us to the end of this video. Due to technical difficulties that I had, my camera didn't work properly and all that. Yet, my eagerness to share this valuable conversation with you outweighed any equipment limitations, basically. Good news is, if you enjoyed this video, think of it as part one. I might ask Dr. Al to do a part two for your questions. So don't forget to like and comment if you'd like to see part two. Special thanks to Dr. Al, one of the nicest people that I've met in the UK. Lastly, don't forget to follow me on Instagram, where I might be sharing potential announcements. Thank you for watching. I hope you found it helpful. See you in the next videos. Bye.